everyone. We are dealing with the chapter Equations of Motion. Okay, from today's class we are going to derive the first equation of motion. Okay, look here. Here you can see x-axis and y-axis of a graph. Okay, in x-axis we want to represent the time. Here I mentioned time as 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, etc. In y-axis, I mentioned the velocity, that is 10 meter per second, then 20 meter per second, etc. Okay. T1 is the initial velocity, that is u. Okay. Then T2 is the final velocity, that is v. Okay. T1 is the initial velocity, that is in 2 second, and T2 is the final velocity, that is in 4 second. Okay. So, I mentioned, from T1, that is in 2 seconds, I am just drawing a perpendicular to the straight line. Okay. Okay, I pointed out this as P. Okay, then 4 seconds. From 4 seconds, I am also drawing just a perpendicular. I mentioned this point as Q. Okay, here I mentioned R and here I mentioned S. Okay, so PQ, S, R. Okay, so from P, I am just drawing a perpendicular to QR. From P, I am just drawing a perpendicular to QR. Okay, I pointed out this as A. Okay, from P, I just drawn a perpendicular to QR and I pointed out this as A. Okay, I think all of you got it. So, we can say area under the velocity time graph is the displacement. Once more, I will say area under the velocity time graph, that is the displacement. From this graph, we can understand that P is the initial velocity and Q is the final velocity. Okay, P lies here in T1 and Q lies in T2, and T1 is the initial velocity and T2 is the final velocity. So P is the initial velocity here, that is U, and Q is the final velocity here, that is V. Okay, from graph we can understand that PS is equal to AR. From once more I will say PS is equal to AR. Okay. PS is equal to AR. So, P is the initial velocity. So, I am writing as U. Okay. Then, QR is the final velocity. That is V. QR is the final velocity. That is V. Okay. Is it clear? So, also, PA is equal to SR. Okay, PA is equal to SR. Okay, PA is equal to SR. Okay, then the time interval T2 to T1, that is final velocity minus initial velocity. Okay, we can consider this as T. Okay, we can consider this as T. Okay, is it clear? From this graph, we want to find AQ. Okay. From this graph, we want to find AQ. Here, AQ is equal to QR minus AR. Okay. AQ is equal to QR minus AR. Is it clear? For finding AQ, we want to subtract QR minus AR. Okay. From this graph, we want to find the acceleration. Acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time. Once more, I will say acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time. Is QR minus AR. Okay. Then consider triangle APQ. Consider triangle APQ, that is triangle APQ. Okay, here A is equal to, that is acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time. Triangle APQ is equal to AQ by AP. Okay, AQ by AP. Here AQ is equal to QR minus AR. AQ is equal to QR minus AR. Then AP is equal to SR. Okay, AP is equal to SR. Is it clear? Here QR minus AR, that is V minus U. QR minus AR, that is V minus U. Okay, so and write QR minus AR is equal to V minus U, and SR is equal to T. Okay, SR is equal to T. Okay, so we can say A is equal to V minus U by T. So cross multiplying this, so A is equal to V minus U by T. Okay, so cross multiplying this, we will get A T is equal to V minus U. Okay, we want to find the final velocity. So I am taking V as outside. So we can write U V is equal to U plus A T. So this is the first equation of motion. V is equal to U plus A T is the first equation of motion. Okay, I think all of you got cleared. It is also known as velocity time relation. These are about today's class. I think all of you got cleared. Thank you.